हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सोशलिज्म इन यूरोप एंड द रशियन रिवॉल्यूशन, यूनिट 3, द फेब्रुअरी रिवॉल्यूशन इन पेट्रोग्राड। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल टेक अ न्यू टॉपिक। इन 3.1 वी टॉक्ड अबाउट द आफ्टर फेब्रुअरी। इन दिस न्यू वीडियो वी टॉक्ड अबाउट द 3.2, द रिवॉल्यूशन ऑफ अक्टूबर 1917। As the conflict between the provincial government and the Bolshevik grew, Lenin feared for the provincial government would set up a dictatorship. In previous video, we saw there was a tussle and there was a struggle between the provincial government as well as a Bolshevik government. And Lenin was the man who led the group of the party that is called Bolshevik Party, and he had a fear that provincial government would be in power and they establish a dictatorship in Russia. So in September he began discussions for an uprising against the government, and so he started agitation against the government, provincial government. Bolshevik supporters in the army, Soviets and factories were brought together. So he talked to the army, he also talked to the Soviets and factories workers, and they came, all of them came together against the provincial government. On 16th October 1917, Lenin persuaded the Petrograd Soviets, and he also persuaded the Petrograd Soviets and the Bolshevik Party to agree to a socialist seizure of power. So he was also make a consensus with the Petrograd Soviets as well as the Bolshevik Party to a socialist seizures of the power. A military revolutionary committees was appointed, a new committee was appointed by Soviet under Leon Trotsky to organize the seizure, and they all wanted to seize the power of the Patriot Soviet provincial government. So he made a consensus among all the different groups of the power, and later on he also talked to the Leon Trotsky to organize the seizure. The date of the event was kept a secret, and there was a secret plan against the provincial government. The uprising began on 24th October. The uprising, the unrest in the people began at 24th October, means there was a huge agitation and revolt against the government. Sensing trouble, Prime Minister Kerensky had left the city. So the Prime Minister left the city and called for or summoned troops. He called the troops to handle the situation. At dawn, military men loyal to the government seized the buildings. At later in the morning time, military men loyal to the government, those soldiers who were loyal towards the government, seized the buildings of two Bolshevik newspaper, and they seized the building, controlled the building of Bolshevik Party and their newspaper centers. Pro-government troops were sent to take over telephone and telegraph offices, and some troops were also would also send to the telephone as well as telegraph offices and protect the Winter Palace, and they also protected the Winter Palaces of the Tsar. In a swift response, a quick response, the Military Revolutionary Committee ordered its supporters to seize government offices. So against it, the Military Revolutionary Committee also ordered to seize the government offices and arrest ministers. So this party, Military Revolutionary Committee, they ordered to seize the government offices as well as arrest the ministers. Late in the day, the ship Aurora shelled the Winter Palace. So a ship was there, and the ship name was Aurora. Shelled the Winter Palaces, and then what happened? Other vessels sailed down the Neva, and the other vessels were also went to the city Neva and took over various military points, and they also controlled the other military points in the western front of the Russia. By nightfall, the east, the city was under the committee's control. By up to night, what happened, the city was under the control of the committee. Committee means Military Revolutionary Committee. Control, and the ministers had surrendered, and all the ministers of the government, they surrendered to the Military Revolutionary Committee. And at a meeting of the all Russian government, all Russian Congress of Soviets in Petrograd, there was a meeting after the seizing of the government. There was a compromise. There was compromise between the all Russian Congress of Soviets in Petrograd. The majority approved the Bolshevik action. The Bolshevik action was against the government, but the majority of the people approved their action against the government. Uprisings took place in other cities. The same action also took place in other parts of the country. There was a heavy fighting, especially in Moscow. There was a fighting, the riot also, as well as there was a struggle among the party members in Moscow, the capital of Russia. But by December, the Bolshevik controlled the Moscow Petrograd area. But later on, in the up to December, means October to December, October, November and December, means within 2 months, they controlled all the places, major places of the political centers like Moscow and Petrograd. That is also the Saint Petersburg. The Bolshevik now in under the full control over the government as well as the country. Look in this picture, we can see the two persons. This is Lenin and Trotsky. Lenin on the left side and Trotsky on the right, with the workers of the Petrograd. These are the workers, and these are the two famous personality of Russia in 1917. Look this details, some important dates of the Russian movements in 1850s to 1880s. Debates over the socialism in Russia. That was a period of the initial socialism in Russia, 1850s to 1880, 30 years. After that, 1898, formation of the Russian Social Democratic Workers' Party. The party was formed in 1898. Then 1905, the Bloody Sunday happened, and the revolution of 1905, we studied in the previous videos. In 1917, in this video, we also learned the 2nd March, the abdication of the Tsar. King left his throne. On 24th October, Bolshevik uprising in Petrograd. Just now we read in this paragraph. In 1918 to 20, the civil war took place in Russia. In 1919, formation of the Comintern, that is a committee. Formation of the they are written in Russian language, it calls Comintern. And in 1929, beginning of the collectivization, which we will read in the coming videos. So this is the last video of Unit 3. This is a Unit 3, the February Revolution in Petrograd. In this video, we covered 3 points. First, then we cover the after February. The important point here is the Lenin April thesis. Then the next, we also covered the Bolshevik party or the provincial government, the revolution of October 1917. In next video, we will go to our next unit, what changed after October. In the next video, we will go through the unit 4. Thank you.